Today I'm covering another one of my favorites, the RTX 40 series, the Ada Lovelace cards. You all might like them. I have mixed feelings. Typically I'm telling people that they are good cards at a very bad price, and the 4060 Ti is the one we're looking at today. I tested this remotely, but there was a PMD involved, and I'll go over exactly how I did it with you in just a second, but it is a Founders Edition, Samsung memory, 128-bit bus, and yeah, it's a regular old 4060 Ti. Card here, actual one I used. Thank you again to Backwards Miner for letting me remote tune this bad boy, but here is the efficiency sheet. And I want to cover a couple things right off the bat, which are new for this card in my testing. One is I'm now color coding the hash rates moving forward to say whether or not the expected hash rate is high enough, in my opinion. So I'm usually comparing it to a similar card. In this case, I'm comparing it to a 3060 Ti, and we're seeing the efficiency is really good on most things. There's very little that's bad about its efficiency. There's mediocre and then there's extremely good. However, there are several coins where this way underperforms what I would have hoped for as far as hash rate is concerned. And a lot of that is due to the 128-bit memory bus. You can brute force it a little bit with the memory clock. It is a pretty good bin on the memory. We were able to get 26 to 2800 offset on this memory, which is like 10,500 megahertz effective or 5,500 megahertz real clock. So the memory performed well. It's you know, breathing through a drinking straw. So flux, it's okay. The hash rate is way lower than you would see with a 3060 Ti, and the efficiency is about the same as a well-tuned 3060 Ti. Nexa, really quite good. Hash rate's good, about the same as you would see from a 3060 Ti, but the efficiency is a lot better. We're like going up from 0.55 to 0.743. So Nexa is one of the things that Ada Lovelace does really well, in my opinion. Dynex, on the fence, a little lower hash rate than a 3060 Ti, but a little bit better efficiency. So we're going from like 5 to 4 on the actual hash rate, and we're going up from about 50 to 56 on the efficiency. So not probably what I would use on that. Kyla, really good. We're almost doubling the hash rate from a 3060 Ti, and the efficiency is better. Everything core did pretty well, which should be no surprise. This isn't gimped as much by the memory bus as everything else we're testing. So the core algorithms, pretty good. The other really huge standout was Cortex. The efficiency I would consider good to be 19 or 20. This is doing 29 mega hash per watt. The only downside is the hash rate's pretty low. I would say it's 30 or 40% lower than I would like to see out of something like this. Kapow, really good efficiency, 0.212. However, the hash rate is about 10 mega hash lower than its predecessor just because of that memory bus. Conflux, again, really low hash rate because we're starting to lean on the memory bus. So it is what it is. I'm not saying the 40 series are bad cards, but when you compare it in efficiency and hash rate to a 3060 Ti or even a 3070, the efficiencies, in my opinion, they're not worth the price doubling. One of these cards still costs about $400 if you're lucky out the door, and 3060 Ti's and 3070s are $200. So in no world of mine does this really make sense unless you are buying this or you got it in a pre-built or something like that already for gaming. So if you happen to have one of these cards, this is, you know, my opinion of what you should potentially consider doing with it if you want to mine. It is very efficient, but the hash rates are kind of all over the place. I would stick to core algorithms probably, but there is the 4060 Ti Founders Edition. Hopefully that was helpful, interesting. If not, whatever, I tried. I'll see you guys on the next one.
You know quantum computers. You know blockchain. But do you know both together? Dynex was the first platform to create a neuromorphic supercomputing blockchain-based algorithm which solves real-world problems. And the best part? Anyone can post a job, whether a company from the Global 2000, a machine learning job, or fintech and pharmaceutical. And if you don't want to program it yourself, get an expert directly at the marketplace. Run the job and be impressed by the fast result.